Hello, I'm Katie from Cranbourne Music, and today we're here with Michael from Cranbourne Music. We'll be talking about humidity and the effect that it has on primarily acoustic guitars. So what's this talk about, humidity?
Okay, well, as you know, Katie, I've recently been to the Taylor factory in America, and we all know that they make wonderful guitars, but in the 4 days I was there, the one thing that they preached at us about every day was the effect of humidity, in other words, the amount of water in the air, on your guitar, particularly your acoustic guitar. They actually suggested that the majority of guitar problems is put down to humidity. In other words, most things that they see in repairs can be fixed by controlling the humidity in the guitar. They will often have a guitar come in that's the action's too high or the action's too low. They put it in a room with controlled humidity, and 2 weeks later that guitar is, without touching anything else, is back to normal.
That's awesome. How can I know what the humidity is?
Okay, that's a good question, because it does vary. So if you come into our store here at Cranbourne, you'll see meters like this all around the place now. And this gives, obviously, the top line is the temperature, but the bottom line is what they call relative humidity. And relative humidity is what we're interested in. It's the amount of moisture in the air at any one time. And it varies with temperature. So as it gets hotter, the air can take in more moisture, so the relative humidity goes down. And we're interested in keeping this number between 40 and 60%. A meter like this is not very expensive. We bought these for about $25 from a local electronics store. We use about 5 or 6 in the shop because, okay, although they're inexpensive, they're reasonably accurate, but if you've got 5 or 6, you can take the average so you know what the average is. That's one way to do it. And you can buy mini ones you can put in your guitar case or something. That's not the only thing that you can do. But that gives you an idea of what humidity is all about. And you can have situations where it gets really low and gets really dry. You know how in summer it seems to get really dry?
Yeah.
And then on other days in summer it gets really humid, it gets really sticky
that
and hot.
Yeah.
And they're the two extremes. So you get this really kind of wet end or you get this really dry end. And we're worried about when it gets to those extremes.
So what happens when your guitar does dry out?
Okay. If it dries out, what will happen is, and let's explain what happens with an acoustic guitar. It's made from wood. And we all know that wood takes water.
Yep.
And what will happen is if your guitar dries out, it'll lose water out of the guitar. And what that means is everything shrinks. The wood shrinks. If it loses water, we've seen what happens when a piece of wood dries out, it all shrivels up. So what happens here is your frets will start to stick out. Your nut can start to stick out. The top of the guitar will sink.
Is that when it starts to buzz?
Yeah.
Yep.
It causes the action to go down and go lower and
yeah.
Buzz. So there's some things. The bridge can lift because if this dips down, the bridge will start to lift away. Yeah. The paint can lift away from the edges. Things like that are signs that the guitar's dried out.
Yeah. So what happens if my guitar gets too wet?
Okay. So we're not talking about sticking in water here. We're talking about it getting wet from the humidity.
Moisture.
You know, I know in the store here at Cranbourne in summertime we run evaporative coolers and because the relative humidity had been turned up for a while, the paper used to get quite sticky at the front.
Mm.
And that's the kind of effect. So what happens with the guitar is it absorbs all the water and it starts to swell up. So it's filling up with water and the frets start to shrink away from the edge because the neck kind of gets a bit wider.
Yeah.
The top of the guitar swells up and that can cause the bridge to lift off. And it causes the strings to come away from the neck, lift up. The action goes up. If the top swells, the strings will go up.
Ah,
the so back swells.
Yeah.
So that it has the opposite effect to what drying out does.
Yeah.
So the guitar can swell. Now, fortunately here in Melbourne, particularly where we are, we have a fairly stable humidity. We're more likely to end up with drier guitars than we are with wet guitars here. Obviously, if you're in Queensland or Darwin, you have the opposite effect. It's really moist and wet. Now, one of the things you've got to remember is, too, this problem is predominantly a problem for solid wood guitars.
Yes.
Not laminated guitars. They tend to be more. They tend to not have as much of a problem. Still got to look after them, but solid wood guitars like Taylors, like Maytons, like Gibsons, like Cole Clarks,
yep.
All of those good high-end guitars are all solid wood guitars.
Yep.
And they're very much prone to it. Your guitar case is made from wood as well. So it comes into the equation. One of the things you've got to remember, however, is that guitar case is covered with vinyl.
Yeah.
So it's kind of an insulated environment. One of the best things you can do is keep your guitar in its case. When you're not using it, keep it in its case. That's a good starting place to keep it stable.
What are the other ways I can keep my guitar safe?
Okay, there's some really good products. And some of these take out the guesswork about humidity. So if you haven't got access to the meter, or you can buy meters like this, as I said, even small ones that you can put in your case. These are better than the mechanical hydrometers. You sometimes see mechanical hydrometers, which is a kind of a round dial. The digital ones are better at displaying the relative humidity. It's generally agreed. But a simple way to do it is, if you suspect that your guitar is particularly dry, a little bit low in things, D'Addario make a really good product. And they make a couple of really good products, but we're going to start with this one, the humidifier. And it's basically a container and you can open the top of it, and there's a sponge inside of it, and there's little breathing holes in the sponge in the side there. And what you do is you get the sponge out, put it in water, and then wring it out so there's no dripping water in it. You put it back in here, and it then fits in between the two middle strings, won't touch the guitar, so there's no water getting on the guitar directly. You put it back in the case and you leave it for 24 hours. Close the lid of the case, of course. In 24 hours, you open it up and have a look at the sponge. And if the sponge is dry, you know the guitar's taken all the water out of the sponge,
right.
It's still dry. You wet the sponge again, wring it out again, put it back so it's still wet in there, it's still damp, but it's not wet. Put it back in the guitar and have a look again in 24 hours. Now that could take a week to 2 weeks, and every 24 hours you might open it up and it might be dry. You know the guitar is still dry, it's still taking the water. Remember, the case is taking its share of water too. And what will happen eventually is you'll get to a point where you'll open the guitar case up and the sponge will still be wet. And you know you're at 50%.
That's when it's worked,
yeah. Then it's worked, and you know you're at what we call 50% humidity.
Yep.
It's stable. Okay, so that means you've rehumidified your guitar. So this is a corrective tool to get your guitar moisture right. What you then do is you swap over to a control tool. And this one is an automatic control system. Basically what this one does is releases and takes in water and keeps the guitar in a controlled environment where basically it stays in that 45 to 55% humidity.
Yeah.
It's made up of two bags. The black one, the black pack here hangs between the guitar strings, and this one goes under the guitar headstock in the case. So again, we're talking about keeping your guitar in its case. Best place to keep your guitar for your acoustic guitar is inside its case, and that'll keep it confined and controlled. What this does is, as I said, if the guitar humidity goes down, it'll release moisture into the guitar case environment. If it starts to go up, it'll take moisture out again. So it's a self-controlling or automatic control procedure. Keeping the case closed at all times when the guitar's in or out of the case.
When it's not in use.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That keeps the stable environment inside the case.
Right.
Pretty simple to do. If you believe your guitar's a bit dry, then use this one to get it up to humidity and then move on to this one. We really do believe it's an important part of looking after your guitar, probably much more than we ever believed in the past. And we're happy to talk to you about it if you've got concerns about your guitar. We work really hard on keeping the environment in our store now at around the 50% mark. You know, most guitars, well, all guitars these days come from the factory really well set up, and it's just a matter of maintaining the environment they're in, and you'll keep those parameters the same. If you want to learn more, come in and have a talk to us. We're only too happy to show you the products or talk to you about your guitar.
We'll be educating ourselves a bit more on it as well, so don't be afraid to ask questions. Thanks for watching our video. I've been Katie.
And I've been Michael.
See you later.
See ya.